Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial we're going to dive deep into the ManyChat user input multiple choice, which I think is a really cool feature because you can use it to make sure that your subscribers are not getting stuck anymore when they type something instead of clicking one of the quick replies. So let's just dive right in and prepare some really cool examples. So these are the examples that I created, but what I first want to do is I want to demonstrate that problem. So usually when you want to ask something and you want to give your subscribers a few options to reply with, you do that like this. You have your question inside a text block and then you set up some quick replies that people can click to give an answer. And then once they do that, the conversation will continue. But the problem with this is that when someone types something here, instead of clicking these quick replies, you see that here, that they're just going to get stuck. Nothing happens, the conversation doesn't continue. And that's very frustrating for the subscriber because they get stuck, they're wondering why is this not working. And it's also frustrating for you because you put the effort in creating these conversations and then you have to help get people unstuck. So not great. So the solution to this is the multiple choice user input. So let's create a new sent message block and then we delete the default text block. And then what I want to do is I want to create a new user input. So this is a pro feature. So you have your user input and then you set the user input to multiple choice. And what the user input basically does is you ask a question and then the user input will wait for a reply from the user before it continues. And that reply can basically be all kinds of different things, right? It can just be a text, just like when you ask an open-ended question, or it can be a number or an email address, a phone number, a URL, a file, an image, location, or a date and time. So plenty of possibilities there. But with the multiple choice, it's really cool that you can basically add multiple quick replies inside your user input. And this is awesome because by doing this, the bot ManyChat will basically wait until the subscriber clicks one of the quick replies and only then do they continue. And if they did not click the quick reply and they maybe typed something, then they're going to get the retry message. So they will get the retry message if their answer was invalid. So if it did not match any of the quick replies, then they're going to get a message that says something like, please select one of the options below. And then there's also a skip button, and the skip button will appear as soon as they give one invalid answer. And then by clicking that button, they can still continue the conversation without giving an answer. But you can also just remove that. I will do that now and I will give you some more examples later on. And then in here, I will ask the same question. Which fruit do you like most? Now, and then I quickly type those in here. I would say bananas, apples, pears or strawberries, right? And then I'm going to drag my block over here so that I can preview it. And what I said earlier is that ManyChat is basically going to wait until one of these things were clicked. So here it says wait for reply from the user. And then you want to continue to another step. So in this case, I want to continue to this message. So I will publish this and preview this so that you can see how this works. So which fruit do you like most? And you see it works, it just looks exactly the same inside Messenger, right? So this time, if I type apple, then we're going to get the retry message. And I think this is awesome because people cannot get stuck anymore. So then it says, please select one of the options below. And then I would say apple. And then it says, yum, thanks for letting me know. Now, then I want to dive into the next example. So the next example is pretty similar, but this time we also use a variable to repeat what they just answered. So here we say, which fruit do you like most? And then the answer that they give, we store into a custom field. So you have the option here, save response to custom field. And I created a new custom field called response so that I can repeat their answer again in this message. Now, and then we also have our retry message. And then you see also that I modified the retry message to, sorry, I didn't get that. Click one of the replies below. I think this is a little bit more friendly, right? And still I did not include a skip button. So let me preview this, show you what that looks like. So here, which fruit do you like most? So again, if I just type something random, then we get our retry message. And if I then click bananas, Then it will say bananas, because that's the word, the reply that we saved into the response custom field, right? So we repeat that inside our conversation and say, we say, thanks for letting me know. Now, then I want to go over to the next example. So it should be down here. And the next example is slightly more advanced, and this includes the skip button. So here we ask, which fruit do you like most? We have our four answers again. And then this time we also included a skip button, and the text for the skip button is set to skip this question. So sometimes you want to include that button so that people, if they do not want to give an answer to your question, that they are not getting stuck anyway because they don't want to answer your question. So by doing this, when they click the skip button, they can just continue the conversation anyway. But what is important is that here, for example, I say response, yum, thanks for letting me know. But if they click skip, then there will be no value here. It will just say yum, thanks for letting me know, while someone clicks skip. So to tackle that, again, we store what they answer into the response custom field, and then we automatically continue to a condition. And then inside this condition, we check if the response has any value. Because before we ask this question, and I should actually drag this over here, before we ask this question, we clear the subscriber custom field called response. So because this is empty, and here we store the answer into the response custom field, there will only be a value inside that custom field when the subscriber gave an answer. So if it has any value, we know, okay, the subscriber answered by clicking one of the quick replies, and then we say response. So for example, bananas, yum, thanks for letting me know. And if it does not have any value, then we follow this red line because this was no match. Then we say, are you sure that you want to skip this question? I can't personalize your experience without an answer. So you can also just, or maybe continue the conversation or change this text, but I like to do something like this. So let me preview this to demonstrate how it works. So first, the custom field response gets cleared, right? Which fruit do you like most? Now then you see here that we have our answers and no skip button, right? But then when I type something, then we get a retry message. Sorry, I didn't get that. Click one of the replies below. We have our four answers. And then we also have our skip button. Skip this question. So if I click this, then there will be no value stored into the response custom field. And then it will continue down here to, are you sure that you want to skip this question? I can't personalize your experience without an answer. And then when someone clicks OK, try again, then we go back to our question here. You see here, whoop, which fruit do you like most? Bananas, strawberries, apples, or pears? So I think that's also a pretty cool use case. Now, then we go to the next one. So the next one is with a free keyboard input. So what we basically do here is we ask a question and then we tell them, hey, you can click one of the quick replies or you can type your own response. So to do that, you have to enable this. Also allow free text input. So usually it looks like this, right? And then you enable this and then you click save response to custom field. So there is not going to be a retry message because whatever they type, they will continue. And there's also no skip button because they can basically not give an invalid answer. So when you enable this and then automatically continue to the next condition, then what you maybe want to do, depends on your use case, is you first want to check, okay, was the response bananas, strawberries, apples, or pears? And what, by the way, is important here is that you uncheck case sensitivity, because here you see that bananas is with a capital B and here it's not. So if you have this enabled, then this will not be a match. So just always uncheck case sensitivity. And then when one of these things is a match, then we know, okay, the subscriber answered one of these questions, and then we continue over here and then we say response variable, yum. If not, if there was no match, then we know, okay, the subscriber gave an answer because they continued, right? Otherwise they would not continue, but they did not click one of these quick replies because there was no match here. So then we just say, thanks for letting me know. So let me quickly preview that. Then you can also see how that works. So which fruit do you like most? Click one of the replies below and type another one. So if I would now here just type apple, then there was no match in quick reply basically because it was not exactly apples. And then we just say, thanks for letting me know. But if I would preview this again, and if I would just click here bananas, then it says bananas, yum, thanks for letting me know, because there was an exact match over here. Now, then I want to show you another cool example. And in this example, I basically want to demonstrate how you can go into different paths inside your flow based on what someone answers, because that's probably what you do most often. So first, again, you clear the subscriber custom field called response. And in this question, slightly different, it's a yes or no question. We ask, do you like bananas? Yes or no? And then we store the response into a custom field called response. We have a retry message and we also have a skip button. Now then, as soon as someone replies to this, so as soon as someone says yes or no, then we continue to the next step, which is a condition. And inside this condition, we check if the response contains yes. And if not, then we check if the response contains no. And if that was also not a match, so if not, if the user does not match any of these conditions, then we follow the red line and then we say, are you sure that you want to skip this question? Because they continued, but this was not a match. We did not have a free keyboard input, so they clicked the skip button. So let me demonstrate that. So over here, so here, do you like bananas? So if I would just type something random, we get the retry message again. And then if I say here, skip this question, then it says, are you sure you want to skip this question? Ok, I will try again. And then if I click yes, I like bananas, then you see that we go to a different path based on that. So if it contains yes, we just continue here. If it contains no, then we continue there. And that was this tutorial about the ManyChat user input multiple choice. I think it's really, really cool. It's just great that your subscribers this way are not going to get stuck anymore. So if you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below. And if you like this tutorial, want to see more like this, then be sure to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.